Good morning, grace and peace to you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I guess I am doing the welcome and announcements. And I don't know of any announcements, but you all, I hope, know what's going on in your family of faith here. But welcome. It is the Lord's Day. It is the second Sunday in Lent. It is a day for us to turn our hearts and our minds toward our Lord Jesus Christ. Will you pray with me? Oh, gracious God, we humbly bow before you, knowing that you're the one who called us to this place. You meet us here. You welcome us in. It's by your love and grace that we live and breathe. And so, Lord, as we gather together and turn our hearts towards you in worship, would you meet us right where we are? Bring glory to your name in all that we do in this time. And we lift this prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
This is the day that the Lord hath made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord hath made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Let us rejoice and be glad. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day that the Lord hath made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
For those who are able, could you please stand and join me in the responsive call to worship. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear?
The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid?
One thing I ask of the Lord, this is what I seek.
To dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. To behold the beauty of the Lord. And to seek him in his sanctuary.
The season of Lent is at hand. The road to Jerusalem, it unsettles us. And the cross reminds us that we fall short of the glory of God. So, with repentant hearts, let us together confess our sins.
Lord Jesus, you came to save a hurting and sinful and broken world. You have brought hope and healing. You taught us how to live and how to love.
yet we continually stumble along the way. We turn our backs on our commands. We seek to justify our wrongdoings. Forgive us for living as ones who think we can make it on our own. Forgive us for forgetting the price you paid on Calvary. Renew us and restore us by your mercy and grace, we pray.
Jesus never fails to meet us on this Lenten journey, guiding us, loving us, and showing us over and over again that we are redeemed and forgiven.
Thanks be to God.
Since God has forgiven us in Christ, let us forgive one another. As we seek to be a community built upon God's shalom, let us greet one another with, "The peace of Christ be with you," and the response is,
"And also with you."